is a really quick video on reCAPTCHA. This is how we're going to help Rebecca and her team crack down on spam they're getting in their current contact form. We'll go to our project settings, and we're setting this up now so that we can reach out to Rebecca and get her this information. Now, while we're at it, let's configure our form information here. Let's configure our from name, Hayes Valley Interior Design website. Subject line can be new contact submission or new message. Okay, we can leave these the way they are. But what we're looking for here is reCAPTCHA validation. Our goal is to get these two keys, the site key and the secret key. Now, a lot of people will do this on their account. A lot of designers, a lot of freelancers will do this on their account. Some prefer to approach their client to do it on their account, so the client holds the reCAPTCHA key. We'll do that version. We'll reach out to Rebecca with that information, but we're going to go through this as an exercise. So when we click this link, let's go back to the Forms tab, and we can see over here there's register for a new key. If we right click on that, we can copy that link address. This is what we'll want to send to Rebecca. And if Rebecca is logged in, as she is in our hypothetical situation here, which we're just using as a demo, she can add this new site. She can register the site to HayesValleyInteriorDesign.com. This is just a label. We'll select reCAPTCHA V2. And all we have to do is we'll use the default robot checkbox. I'm not a robot checkbox. And we'll just copy this and paste it into the domains field. That's what we want in terms of this validation. We want to make sure Hayes Valley Interior Design is added. Then the second thing we're going to ask for is this. We're going to get HayesValley.webflow.io. We want our client to add this second piece of information. And the reason we're doing that is when we're staging the site, when we're testing it, we don't want to publish the site we're working on here. We want to publish to our staging domain. So we're going to make sure both of these are there. We're imagining this is Rebecca. This is what Rebecca's going through. So she'll be the owner here. We're going to accept and we'll hit submit. And once we do that, Rebecca will get, or if you do this, you'll get a site key and a secret key. We'll copy these and put them in for now. But in our hypothetical scenario, we'll be pasting these in when Rebecca sends them to us. We'll hit save changes, and that's adding reCAPTCHA validation. We'll come back, we'll enable this, and we'll configure this in our forms later.